please excuse this braid. I don't know why it's like all crinkled up instead of straight like the other one, but it is what it is. Hey guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Crystal. So today the video is going to be a little bit different than what I've been posting lately. Today I'll be dyeing my first ever blonde wig, as it says in the title. And I'm really excited just to show you guys a process. I'm not a professional or anything like that. This is the first time I'm doing it. So I just kind of want to show my experience and how I do it. And if it's a good thing, if it turns out good or turns out bad, hey, at least we tried and now we know. I'm going to try my best not to mess it up because I really want to use this. I actually want to have this wig done because I have a really awesome Valentine's Day video planned for you guys. And I feel like just blonde hair would be so pretty for Valentine's Day, you know? Enough of that. What's important is the wig itself. Excuse the frizz. I dropped it a few times before I started recording, but it's fine. Like, it's no tangles whatsoever. The hair is still really soft. The only problem is, I mean, that yellowy color, you know, like the Barbie doll hair color of, I just don't feel like it complements my skin. So I just want to color it, tone that yellow down and get just a really pretty color. This is a 26 inch 13x4 lace wig and it's really nice. Like I said, super soft, and I just can't wait to see the outcome. I hope it's what I planned. So I did find quite a few videos on how to dye blonde wigs. Finally found one that I felt comfortable with and I love the outcome. Today I'll be mixing these three colors. And because it's a human hair wig, I need to use human hair color. And so this is the L'Oreal Preference LB01. And this would be Revlon Color Silk. And this is number 70, I believe. And the last one is Revlon Color Silk as well, but this would be 04. That's important. In her video, she didn't mix all three of these colors. She saturated the hair, she let it sit, washed it, rinsed it out, and then she let it air dry. The things that stood out to me in her videos that were different from the other ones I saw was, one, she did mix three different colors, which gives you just a better color instead of just one flat color. And then also she let it air dry. I want to do that as well. Like I said, I want this wig for Valentine's Day, so I'm starting on this a little bit early. Today is actually the 2nd of February. And so I'm going to go ahead and do this today. That way, in case it does dry and maybe there's some patches or there's not the right color, I'll have the chance to use those extra dyes that I picked up to kind of blend it in and kind of change it up and fix it to where I want it to be before I need to install it for Valentine's Day. So I'm gonna go ahead and get started on that, but I did wanna mention, I did pick up this wine here at Walmart while I was out. I'm gonna go ahead and pop this in the fridge while I'm doing the hair just so it can chill down. That way, once I'm done, I can have a glass or two and I'll let you guys know how it goes. And as far as install, I probably won't show that only because I'm still fairly new at installing. I feel like I do a pretty decent job, but I don't know if anybody would like to see that. If you would like to see that, definitely let me know in the comments. I'd love to post that video. And so you guys can see my beginner method of installing a lace wig. But enough of all the chit chat. Let's go ahead and get into the real reason you're here, dyeing the wig. I hope you guys enjoy. So this is basically everything I'm gonna be using. The hair color that I showed you guys before, a brush to apply the color, gloves, obviously, a bowl to mix it all in, a comb, some pins to hold the wig, and then a hair clip to hold the hair as I do this. I did wrap the mannequin head in saran wrap. I found this was a really good trick just to keep the hair color or dye off of the fabric itself. And then I'm just securing the wig down with a couple of T-pins just for a little bit of extra security. I will say the saran wrap was a really good idea. I wish I would have wrapped it better, and you'll see why later in the video. So I start with mixing up the hair color. I take them out individually. I read their instructions. They're pretty much the same. So I just mix the small bottle into the big bottle, shake it up for a bit. Once each one is shaken up, I'll go ahead and add them to the bowl you see there. And then once I mix those up, then I'll apply it to the hair. I will say this, this wig is 26 inches long and it's 180 density. When I tell you I was scraping the bowl, I was scraping the bowl. Don't think you can miss out on having just one or two of these colors.
getting three is really important. Even if you have to get like two of one color and then the other in case you don't have it at your store, definitely getting three boxes is what you need to saturate all the hair thoroughly. I do want to start by just apologizing to any hairstylist or salon professional. I did not do sections, as you see. I do regret that. I didn't think of it until I was halfway through, but it's all good. It still worked, but definitely do sections. Don't do this. Sections are key. Sections help you move quickly, and it's such an easier process. So don't make it harder for yourself. Just do the sections. But I do saturate each strand. I try my very best, and I even make sure that I get some onto the roots just to make sure that everything gets colored. I didn't want to have, you know, the rest of the hair be the color I wanted, like the ashy gray, and then let's say the roots were yellow, that would just look horrible. So I really work all the product into each strand, each little piece that I pull out, and then rub it into the roots just to make sure it's covered.
I like that one.
So this is the prime reason why I said do sections. As you can see, the bottom half of the hair is like almost a darkish gray color. I was freaking out. So you see I'm working like twice as fast. I'm just trying to make sure each strand is coated and I'm really getting it into the roots. Like I said, I'm just showing you how detailed I was being. I wanted to make sure I was getting just about every weft right at the root, just to make sure that it was colored. I didn't want any yellow to be peeking through, so I was being very detailed. I know it looks a little concerning right now that it's that gray, but it ends up not being as bad. I was very much stressed and I tried to move as quick as I could. And so this is me showing you how I just detangle the hair before I start coloring. I just want to make sure everything is smooth and easy to work through. And then I apply again at the root, and then I get a small section, apply at that root, and then start getting more and more as I go. From drinking more alcohol for the past 5 days. Did you check on me? Now did you look for me? I walked in the room, eyes are red, and I don't smoke banga. Did you check on me? Did you check on me? Now did you notice me? Nobody we know the paranoia. Cause I put a smile on my face, a facade you can never face. See, I left the wig on the mannequin head because it was wrapped in saran wrap. This was like a last minute idea and it worked out really good. The more I washed, the more wet the mannequin head got, so I kind of gave up after a little while. But notice how as I'm rinsing the color out, the hair isn't as dark as it looked with the color on it, and it turns out to be really good, but I can start noticing patches of brighter spots compared to the darker gray areas. As I'm washing it, I only use conditioner and I just do a very thorough scrub and then a very thorough rinse. At this point, I realize it's almost perfectly the color that I was aiming for. Can we just appreciate the lashes? My lash tech did her thing. And this is like her classic with wispy, and it really was a good price. She did it really quickly. I've been going to her for a few months and I just really like her work. Sorry, that was super random. Anyways, so I just got done with the wig. As you guys saw, I made a few mistakes, which is fine. I knew it wouldn't be perfect since this was my first time, so I'm not really sweating it. Plus, if I did make a mistake, once it dries, I'll be able to tell more and then I'll be able to just go in and correct it here and there where it needs to be. That's why I got extra dye. So right now I'm just letting it dry. I want to show you guys now, but I feel like you'll get the full effect after a day of just drying. So like I said, I'm air drying it. So I'll probably show you guys a picture or a small clip of it tomorrow after 24 hours of it drying. And then from there, if I find any little pieces that I need to touch up, I'll go ahead and do it then and get it out the way. That way I can have it ready for next week. And Cricket's drinking water, so I'll go ahead and end the video here.
Hey
Hey guys, I honestly almost forgot to show you like a 24-hour update of it air drying. So it's actually been like 27 hours, so even better. But it's actually just still a little bit wet, but I do love the way that it came out. It still has, like, I don't know the best way to say it. Some spots are lighter than others. It came out a little bit more gray. I guess you can see compared to my skin. It came out a little bit more gray than I expected. I don't know if it's just the camera light, but if you can really see the color. But yeah, it's really close to that, like almost white kind of blonde, but it still has a little yellow, a little gray to it. I know it has like a little gray on the roots. I don't know, I'm not too worried about it. I feel like that may just be the look of it since I haven't tinted the actual lace. So it'll be what it is, but yep, I'm actually super excited. I love the way that it did come out. The hair is still, I mean, again, guys, super soft. And I noticed very little shedding, like very minimal shedding throughout the wash and while it's drying, so. Almost made you happy, almost made you cry, almost made you happy, babe. Didn't I, didn't I? You almost had me thinking you were turned around, but everybody knows, almost let go. Almost heard you saying you were finally free. We was always missing for you, babe. You found it in me, but you can't get to heaven.
Most of the hair was dry from air drying, but there were a few spots that just needed a little bit of attention. I didn't want to wait any longer, so that's why I went in with my hair dryer. This is a completed dry look. It looks perfect. It's exactly what I wanted. So then I go in with my heat protectant spray. I love it. It smells really good and it works well. So I do section small pieces at a time, put a little heat protectant on it, comb it out, and then I make a few passes with my straightener. And I know I've had this straightener for a really long time. I don't even want to say the amount of years. I definitely need to get a new one, but it still works and I love it. So it's just my go-to. It's very slight, so I'm not sure if you can notice, but a little bit of heat actually brings back the yellow color to it. So be cautious of that. The more heat you apply, even if it's blow drying, any kind of heat is going to bring out that yellow tone. So if you want to keep it the same color, I was just using very little heat. I only used the lowest setting on my straightener, which was about 325 degrees. I know that doesn't sound really low, but that's just as low as mine goes. I did do just about 2 to 3 passes per small section. Again, making sure I just get everything together in uniform so I can get a better idea of basically how bad it was. It wasn't too bad. Like I said, there were some small spots where I could have done a little bit better, but seeing as it was my first time, I didn't mind it. So I just know how to perfect it better later. Y'all see those roots, right? Mm-hmm. That pretty gray color. That's exactly what I wanted. And it really came out so good. That's one of the things I'm the most proud about. You can see some of the streaks of hair. They're a little bit more blonde, more yellow than the rest, but again, that's because I was scraping the bowl for some of that hair dye because I put too much on the bottom. And yeah, my light went out, it died, so I'm just gonna finish it up. And then here you're gonna actually see there's one small section on the roots that apparently didn't get any dye, which I'm not sure how, but we all know how. A part of me really wanted to open up one of the extra boxes of color dye that I got, but I thought it'd be a little bit of a waste since that was just a small spot and there were only a few streaks, I would say, that needed some attention, and I didn't want to risk it. So I kind of just kept it and just rolled with the punches. Honestly, it turned out really good and I don't even see it once I have it installed, all because I tinted the lace really well. And I will let you guys know this, blonde hair is very high maintenance. So be very cautious of the heat. Definitely use a heat protectant and just be prepared to have flyaways and little things like that. And this is several days later. I was gonna get ready to install the wig, so I thought what better time than to tint the lace. As you can see, it's not gonna be transparent, so we gotta fix that. I laid down a towel just for protection, and then I just want to examine the lace, seeing what I need to do. I was so concerned because this is blonde hair, and you can see there's that same little patch that I showed you guys when I straightened the hair at the front. So I'm gonna go in with the tinted lace Eben spray. I'm not sure if it's Eben or Ebon, but you know what I'm talking about. And this is the perfect color for me. I've used it on all my other wigs, but granted they were black, so it wasn't too concerning. I go in very lightly. When I say lightly, I mean lightly. Like, I was so scared to put any pressure on the cap and spray it, because we all know that spray is aggressive. So I am just flipping it over, like making sure, like, did it go through? Is the hair tinted? What's happening? What do the roots look like? I was very scared. Thankfully, it didn't go through too bad. So I thought, okay, I'll just keep going lightly, and working it that way. So I flip it back inside out very gently, not trying to tint the hair. And then I go back in with just a little more spray here and there, just trying to make it look good. And I didn't end up using any foundation or anything like that. All I needed was the tinted spray, so that was really nice. I will say this, especially when you're doing the edges, I would be very light with that. Some of it did get through. It didn't right there, but further up on the hairline, closer to the middle, it did get through. So some of the hair strands were a little brown. It didn't really come out as quickly as I thought it would. I tried to use like rubbing alcohol, water, and it didn't really help. So being very delicate with it, since it is blonde hair, you don't want to make an error. It will go through the lace. So just be very light, very delicate with it. Y'all saw my camera fall, right? Like, how rude, like the disrespect. Anyways, so this is just me styling the wig. I did install it off camera only because, like I said in the beginning of the video, I didn't want to bore you guys with it. It literally takes me hours because I'm still getting used to how to do it. I've only done it about 4 times and it's just a long process for me. And so I didn't show on camera, but I did go in with a wax stick at the top. And then I also did it in the front so I could just calm those flyaways down. And then I did use heat protectant spray all over the hair so it's nice and protected. Right here, you can see just how pretty the color is. And I am just in love with it. I'm just trying to figure out whether I want a middle part or a side part. I did go in with a middle part and the end of it. I just don't... Personally, with me, I don't feel like a middle part looks too good, and I'm trying to get used to that look on me. And I think it looked really nice right here, so I might keep it for just a few days and then may switch it up to a side part like I normally do. So just basic styling. I go in with the hot comb all over. I try to make the wig as flat as I can. You know, it's really easy for a blonde wig to look wiggy. Like, it takes literally no effort. So I'm just trying to be delicate with the hair and also trying to get it to cooperate because I want a really nice flat finish. And so as I'm hot combing, you'll see later, I start doing little things here and there. I don't know what that was. I think I was trying to read a notification. But I go in with my straightener. At first, I thought maybe straight will be the way to go. And then I ended up doing some small curls in it, and I really like the curls, so I might have to go in with a curling wand later to do real curls, or maybe even do barrel curls and let it sit for a little while. I didn't do any baby hairs. I like the way that it looked as is. I also did not pluck the hairline. I'm not sure if you can do that. To me, I feel like it looks really good without it being plucked. But again, that's just my personal preference. And then also the no baby hairs. You know, this is my wig. If you want to do baby hairs, do baby hairs. I just thought it looked really nice without it. So I just kind of kept going with that. And then here is me attempting to do curls. I do go in and kind of fix it up and change it up a little bit later. But so far, I really like the way that they came out. I used a lot of hairspray to hold it, not like oil sheen, but like actual freeze hold spray. And then this is me just getting started to just fluff it out, finger comb it, and then try to make it look good. And this is the back. It's so flowy, so soft still. And I just really love the outcome. And I really hope you guys enjoy the video. And so I can't wait for you guys to see the end result once I get just a little bit of makeup on. Nothing too crazy, but like I said, I was getting ready to go out. And so if you want to see me all done up, definitely check out my next video. It's going to be a vlog for Valentine's Day. I'll be posting it on Valentine's Day. So definitely come to my channel and check that out on the 14th. Definitely comment below if you like this video. Also, if you want to dye your own wig and you follow these steps, let me know. I would love to see how it comes out and if you love it as much as I love mine. Other than that, thank you so much for watching and I hope to see you guys soon.
Stop playing.